भजतां कल्पवृक्षाय नमतां कामधेनवे वयभक्तिमभ्या अग्रादि संभेदना दृष्टि वज्रो क्षमा सुरेंद्रवतु मां सधाय। नमस्ते ऑल, थैंक यू फॉर मेंटेनिंग द साइलेंस। With the grace of Sri Guru Raghavendra Swamiji and blessings of Sri Sugunetri Venkata Krishna Brindavana Tungavi Sydney, we welcome you all to this divine occasion to celebrate Sri Guru Raghavendra Aradhane. This is a great opportunity for us to share some activities and information about SVKV. In future, I will be referring Sri Venkata Krishna Brindavana as SVKV, just to keep it short. Sri Krishna Vana was started last year on the 10th of February by Sri Gunendra Tirtha Swamiji of Puttigai Matha in Udupi, which is one of the Ashtamada formed by Sri Madhvacharya. Sugunendra Swamiji is a visionary who boldly left the shores of India, considered as a taboo for saints, to take on the responsibility of showing the right path of spirituality and salvation to millions of Hindus around the world. His vision is to establish 108 mathas in different countries, in as many countries as he can, and he has established mathas in US, UK, Canada and Australia. In Australia itself, we have Sydney and Melbourne. It becomes our duty to support such efforts by institutions like Krishna Vrindavana, who with their year-long activity not only provide us an opportunity to experience the divinity, but also help us to keep our culture, teach our young children on our practices, and ensure we as a community keep our heritage. Here are some of the Samohika activities conducted throughout the year, which I'll just be reading out. Shivaratri, Yugadi, Gana Homa on Sankashta Chaturthi, Satyanarayana Puja on Guru Purnima, Navadurga Puja is celebrated 9 days in Navaratri, Deepavali, Sri Varamahalakshmi Puja and many more. Apart from the above, every Monday they celebrate Rudra Parayana and Rudrabhisheka at temple, Durga Puja on every Amavasya. In the same token, SVKV has fully trained priests who perform household religious activities like Griha Pravesha, Satyanarayana Puja, various types of Homa, many more samskaras like wedding, Upanayana, and those who are given the right to perform the Shraddha. All this information, I know it's way too much to take in, but you can always access this information in SVKV website. Also note, they have Bhagavad Gita classes, Japa Stotra classes are conducted every Saturday at the temple for those who are interested. Newly added activity is summer camp for children, where they will be taught simple shlokas, puja vidana, and also cooking, bhajans, and many more. These activities will be a great way for our children to understand our religious practices and realize the full benefits of it. Sugunendra Tirtha Swamiji is committed to his vision of showing the path of spirituality through the establishment of places of worship like Krishna Vrindavana. He has established this all around the world, and it's a great opportunity for all of us to be involved in various capacities through this. And on behalf of Krishna Matha, I request all the devotees here to participate in any capacity by volunteering or managing many of the activities that is conducted throughout the year. Most important, you can donate much required funds to be able to perform, celebrate these functions and work towards building Krishna Vrindavana in Sydney, which can serve as a knowledge center to spread spirituality and keep our rich culture heritage part of our lives. To know more about the temple and the timings of the temple, please visit their website. You can follow them on Facebook or WhatsApp, or if you are kind enough to share your email addresses today, all the activities will be communicated through email. Last but not least, Krishna Temple Tungavi, please visit them. They have 3 daily pujas that's performed morning, afternoon and evening. All devotees are most welcome to be part of these puja, and like any other South Indian temple, they also do annadana for the puja done on afternoon and evening. So let us all be part of this spiritual journey, and we are looking forward for your continued participation. I take this opportunity to thank all the devotees who have assembled here for your participation, and all the volunteers for their hard work, and the sponsors who made this function a great success. And I also thank the temple authorities of Helensburg for giving us the space. Dhanyavaad.